Hi, for today's demo, I'm going to share with you the workflow for prototyping a simple audio stream playback control with Axure. By leveraging the web browser that we use to render our prototype, we can actually emulate the experience of having a real audio playback control that found in a typical music app as shown here. The idea behind these techniques is mainly powered by the JavaScript that runs in a web browser. To do so, first, we need to create an audio holder that made out of dynamic panel in Axure, then load it with an audio stream of your choice. Later, you will just need to create a play and a pause button with an on-click event listener that had some JavaScript attached to it. To follow this tutorial, first go to download and open up this code snippets document, then grab all of them and paste it onto the Axure's workspace temporarily. As a demo, I'm going to park it over here, and you can delete this snippet later when you are done. Next, let's drag a placeholder widget into the workspace and customize it as if some album cover for an audiobook. Okay, now let's pull a dynamic panel out and resize it to fit under the placeholder. Remember to give it an instance name. You can also give the album cover a label too, even though we are not going to attach any JavaScript to it. Next, we are going to copy this chunk of JavaScript snippet and then go to the properties panel and look out for the onload event listener. You can click on the more events drop-down menu here if you can't locate the onload handler. Now go to double-click on the handler so that we can call up the case editor and paste in the JavaScript. You can replace this audio stream anytime as you see fit, but for now, let's just stick with this provided sample. Next, we are going to add a pause button and the play button for our prototype. Now go to copy the play function snippet, but before you attach it with an on-click listener, remember to keep a habit for giving the button an instance name. Next, just repeat the copy and pasting step for the pause button as well. Now let's preview our prototype and see if there are any errors. Okay,
this is a LibriVox
the play button
recording.
Is working well.
All LibriVox recordings are in the public domain. For more information or to volunteer, please visit LibriVox.org.
But the pause button seems to be not working. Let's head back to Axure and check it out. Okay, I have made a mistake. I have misplaced the play function into the pause button. Let's open up the case editor and fix it from here. Now let's do another preview and see whether we have fixed the problem.
This is a LibriVox recording. All LibriVox recordings are in the public domain.
Alright, everything is working the way it should. Let's head back to Axure and continue to set up the playback console. This time we are going to select both of these buttons and convert it to a dynamic panel. At the outline page, let's duplicate the default state want and rename it to pause. You can hit the keyboard shortcut key of F2 for changing the label of state want to play. Next, double click on the play state here for entering the editing mode. We are going to delete the pause button for the play state. And then remove the play button that found in the pause state. Here you can reset the location of the pause button to the origin. Next, we need to set up a simple switch event that enables the user to trigger the play and the pause function. Okay, let's do another round of preview again, and test out the playback button again.
This is a LibriVox recording.
It should be working as the way I've demonstrated here. For the final step, we will need to hide the default HTML audio playback console here. Let's head back to Axure, open up the case editor, and add a show and hide action. Preview again, and it won't be visible to anyone now. So by combining today's demo with the porting technique that I've shared with you on the other day, you should be able to prototype a realistic audio app and use it for usability testing purposes. And that's all for now. Thank you.